Hey there, and welcome back to our channel. In this video, we're gonna dive into what you need to check out, which is this community forum template inside of Softr. Having a community forum means that users inside of your community can engage with your brand and have a deeper connection with it. Customers are going to be able to enrich their experience with something like this. And this template that we have for you at softr.io/templates has a myriad of different functionalities, from various types of user accounts to posts, comments, and votes, moderation, searching and filtering, as well as a beautiful responsive design. This template is exactly what you need to get started with community forums. So if we click right here and press use template, we can dive right into building this. So if I press use template and then select a data source, I can press continue and copy this base to my Airtable account, press add base, press create application, and get started. Now, also a quick note on this one, you actually have the ability to go through and preview this template prior to installing it, just to get a look at how it works overall. But let's preview this to get started. So first of all, on the homepage, you have a hello and welcome to our community forum section, which is essentially this home form. And there's this join now option, which then forwards to an email. But you can adjust this to do different things. You don't have to have it forward to an email. There are various different options to have it connect to, but this is a great start. So you can change this to whatever your email is. For example, dimitri@softr.io, where this could forward. Now, when I look at the community forum base that I added, there is a user section, post table, and a comments table. So essentially the post table is where all of the community forum posts are going to be housed, with the time posted, who the author is, their email, category, different attachments and links, as well as votes. And then the comment section is very similar in the sense that it comes from all the different users and our comments based on the posts. So we can see that after taking a look at this from a signed in perspective. So let's look at this as Joe, who's somebody who would be in the community and signed in. All right, so now that I'm in as Joe, I can actually press create post. And you'll notice that in the back end on the homepage, what happens is you have the visibility of seeing this section and this section once you are logged in. And then for the Airtable base, you'll see that it ends up adding whatever you put into this create post button by going to this modal new post, which is hidden back here. And once again, its visibility is limited on a page level, as you can see right here, by all logged in users. So this is essentially going to connect to your community forum by Softr base and specifically the Airtable table. So within this, we're able to select a category like discussion, feedback, personal stories, tools and resources, tutorials. And if I were to put something like discussion category, write out something like test or not for the title, then ask a question, is it better to ship fast and evaluate on production or test beforehand in preview modes? And then add any different files or links that I wanted, press post, and then we'll get sent back to this page. And then you'll notice at the bottom here inside of Airtable, we have this test or not that was inputted by Joe, and it was posted at my time at 8 a.m. It should pop up within here as well if I press discussion. And then you can see that this was submitted. If we look up Joe here, you'll see he asked this question here on 10-4 at 8 a.m. And if I click inside of this, we then would see the details inside of this on the post details page. And if I wanted to, I then could edit the post to change the name. So test or not, and just press save, and you'll see that this will update the title of the post right here. And then if I was someone in the community, I could go here and then add a comment like, in my opinion, it's better to release quality over quick and quantity to keep your customers trusting you with your product quality assurance. Then when I comment, you'll see right here that it showcases the person that comments. Comment should pop up within here. See Joe ends up commenting. Has the comment field and what they said right here, has the record ID of them doing it, the time, all very nice and formatted in there. And for the most part, that's pretty much what you can see within here. You can go to the top post page and kind of see what the top upvoted things are. You can filter to different categories within this as somebody from this perspective. And you obviously can press create post on the top right and it'll bring you here. But as a moderator, if I go here, you also can create posts. You also can see this here and then go to recent posts. Go inside of the different community posts within here. I love the fact that when I press this upvote, it does sort on the top posts section and showcase what's most recent. The difference between those two pages for top posts and most recent posts is if I go to this right here and then scroll down, you'll see that it's sorted by Z to A, which would be biggest to smallest, and then vote count. Whereas on the recent posts, which is actually just the homepage, you can sort this, for example, by time posted Z to A, and you'll notice that most recent one popped up here that I just put with Joe. So it's a very simple system, right? We can gatekeep this entire thing by having somebody need to be added via submitting an email, and then in the back end, adding them as a user if you'd like. If we added a new user like me, and then pressed add user, I'd be added into the system. And then from there, based on whatever user group they're in, they'd have different permissions. But overall, this system is a very simple and effective way of getting the insights that you as a lead can bring together all the different ideas that people have in your community so that you allow their voices to be heard. If you like this video and want to check out more content from us at Softr, make sure to check out videos like this one to teach you how to use Softr even more.